So, Coach, prior to the NBA restart, I looked in on some of your practices, and they look good. They look chippy. They look strong. So I got two questions for you. What did you learn in the bubble, and how do you plan on playing without Ben Simmons, even though you've been struggling with him in the first three?
I'm going to say something that sounds funny, but I've learned this. Offense, defense.
Wait, are you telling me you just learned defense in the bubble? Are you kidding me, Coach?
But Jack asked.
Whoa, no need for that harsh language. I understand that times are not good for you. Your job is on the line. But can you continue to the second question, please?
Go back to the big picture of what you're asking. For sure, you knew you needed something to compete with that. It needed to go apples for apples.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Okay, Coach, put your mask on. I think we had enough for today. We had one more question, but I see that we're not getting anywhere with these answers, so I think you should head back to your hotel. Actually, let me ask that one last question. So can you take your mask down one more time, try to get this answer right, or just give me something? It's about Al Horford. How did he play? Knowing that he only had 2 points and 10 rebounds, what did you think?
I thought that he came in and, like you said, you know, he had 10 defensive rebounds. He had 5 assists. You know, he didn't, I think he had, 3 shots, but he was plus 18. Like, there was a stage he came in, I think it was at the end of the third. You could just feel stuff changed, and it was really, to me, the thumbprint that he put on it.
Well, I'm out, man. That nigga's tripping.
What is going on, everybody? For those who don't know, I go by Philly Mike, and this is the Philly Tall Podcast. If you are new to the channel and love talking Philly sports every single day, hit that subscribe button. Now, we not at our normal spot, but I wanted to get a quick video out prior to the Sixers and Magic game tonight. So I thought let's do a car video. And I want to talk about the rotation going forward without Ben Simmons before this game, a little bit about this game, but just in general, through the bubble games into the playoffs. And if you feel like the Sixers are going to have an uphill climb to even get out the first round without Ben Simmons, but are still going to watch, smash that like button. With all that being said, let's jump into today's topic. Before we get into this video, I had to talk about Brett Brown. You know how we feel about him. I know how yous do. I know how I do. But at the end of the day, he's going to be the head coach for the Philadelphia 76ers until the end of this bubble and the playoffs. And so we're going to have an uphill climb when it comes to the first round, getting past his coaching, getting past the fact that Ben Simmons won't be there. And yes, his defense has not been good in the bubble, but still, what he can do in transition, on the ball defense, all that stuff, he still makes this team better. And we will be better with Ben Simmons when we have a new coach. But let's get into the rotation on what it's going to look like past Ben Simmons and how many guys are going to get the chance to play the rest of this bubble and into the playoffs. That's what I'm curious about, because when this season's over, if and when we get rid of Brent Brown, I want to know who else is on this roster. Are we going to keep around Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid? Will Alex Burks prove that he should be here next year? Shake Milton, a young guy who I like a lot. Some people were getting sour on him after one game, but I like him. Will he be able to step up and have a key role next year? Al Horford, how is he going to fit? We got to do something with that contract. I mean, guys like Glenn Robinson, Furkan Korkmaz, Matisse Thybulle, these guys never played minutes in the playoffs. Furkan wasn't getting no minutes last year. Matisse Thybulle wasn't here last year. Shake Milton was in the G League last year. And Alex Burke was on a different team. So these guys, I want to see the rotation that Brent Brown does. I mean, who knows? He'll probably put in Raul Neto. I don't know. But I want to see Burks in the playoffs, Korkmaz in the playoffs, Matisse in the playoffs, Shake Milton in the playoffs. These minutes are important. Now, Joel Embiid is going to be that guy. Tobias is going to play a little bit. Richardson is going to play a bit. But we're going to go as far as Joel Embiid takes us. The first round exit is a true possibility with Brent Brown's coaching and the lack of Ben Simmons. The way we've been already playing, I'm not saying we can't win in the first round because Joel Embiid at times can be special. And against the Celtics where he can physically drop 35 any night, who knows? But that's what it's going to take to get past the first round. But let's get back to the rotations. I need to see big minutes from Shake, and I need to see Shake not scared to shoot. I need to see Alex Burke off the bench playing 20 plus minutes now. I need to see guys like Korksma shooting their shots and not afraid of the moment. So to me, these playoffs are kind of important to get these guys that we might have to keep on the roster in 2021 alongside of Ben, alongside of Joe, with a new coach. So it's important to see how these guys handle this. That's my thoughts. And again, against the Magic today, we're both 2-1 in the bubble. The Magic are 32-37 overall. You already know we are 41-27. Like I said, both 2-1 in the bubble. Since the bubble game started, Joel Embiid has been playing out of his mind. 41, 27, 30 points. But this will be his toughest matchup against a center. Vucevic, or however you say his name, is not the best center, but he's a sturdy center. He's going to play some offense. He's going to play some defense. I like the matchup, but I still think that there's no center that can really stop Joel Embiid. Just slow him down. So I'm curious to see how Joel Embiid does tonight when he is the solo act superstar on the team with the guys around him. I'm curious how the spacing is going to look. Now, they got some shooters, Fournier, Ross, Gordon, but I still think the Sixers team without Ben Simmons can beat them if we get a dominant Joel Embiid. Like I said, the lack of Ben Simmons being there is going to show throughout the remaining of the season and into the playoffs. But if the Sixers can somehow just play ball, I'm still going to watch. Like I said, it's hard to know that they're playing, and I'm just not going to watch. So I'm going to continue to complain. I'm going to continue to cheer, and I'm just ready to see Sixers basketball when we're at full capacity with a new guy at the helm. Because even if some people want to say Brett Brown is not the worst coach in the world, it's time for a change. He's bad, but it's just time for a new culture, a new change, someone who's going to push Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid to be the best they can be. That's all that's saying. So I'm curious to see how these matchups go. I want to see Embiid versus Vooch. And I want to see these young guys shine in the next couple games into the playoffs. Shake, Furkan, Alex Burke, Matisse, all these guys getting minutes, because some of these guys are going to be a part of their 2021 roster. And I need to see it night and the rest of the season. So with that being said, thank you guys for watching, all the constant support. Let me know in the comment section, who do you think's going to be able to step up alongside of Joel Embiid? Not Tobias Harris, because we know he needs to. Even Josh Richardson. Will some of these guys step up to make their name going into next season? A first round exit is a real possibility without Ben Simmons. But for next season, who's going to be that guy that says, wow, we need them to play with Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid? Because a new coach could even make them better. Will it be Furkan? Will it be Shake? Will it be Matisse? Will it be Alex Burke, who's not a young guy, but a new guy on the Sixers? I just can't wait to see the rotation. Al Horford, even though he doesn't play great with Joel Embiid, he's going to have to step up and play big, especially on the defensive side of the ball. Until next time, you know what time it is. We out.